Hi everyone. Today I want to share with you the story of my MacBook Pro battery and how I fixed the problem. A few months ago, my MacBook Pro started to shut down randomly while the battery power reached 40, 30, 45, 20, and sometimes 50%. And displayed the service battery warning. I tried a few suggestions to troubleshoot the issue, such as resetting the SMC and the PRAM. Unfortunately, none of the suggested solutions were effective. I took my laptop to the Apple store in my city and talked to one of the Apple employees. He told me that the battery needed to be replaced and it would cost around 21,780 yen, about 192 US dollars. I thought it was a ripoff. I told the Apple employee I would think about it and left the store. After watching a few video clips on YouTube, I decided to replace the battery myself, so I searched on Amazon and bought one battery, which came with four screwdrivers and a plastic spatula for 7,799 yen, about 69 US dollars. And this is the battery I ordered on Amazon. When I received the package, there were no screwdrivers in the box. And this is the package I received. And the screwdrivers supposed to be here. But as you can see, there were no screwdrivers. I didn't want to write a complaint letter and wait 1 or 2 weeks to resolve the issue. Instead, I went to a store and bought some screwdrivers and plastic spatulas to remove the battery. These are the tools I bought to remove the batteries. The next day, I spent 2 hours and eventually managed to install the new battery. It's a risky job. You can easily damage your computer. However, I wanted to do it myself. After the installation finished, I turned on my MacBook, but I couldn't see the battery icon in the menu bar and couldn't run my MacBook on battery. I thought I wasted my time and money. So the battery icon, as you can see, this is the battery icon. Okay, that time I couldn't see this battery icon here. Feeling disappointed, I started using my laptop while connected to the power outlet and had no problems. After 3 weeks, I took it to the Apple store again, talked to the same guy, and asked them to replace the battery. I thought the battery I bought from Amazon could be faulty, but I was not sure about it. After 2 days, I received an email from an Apple technician stating that he had found another issue with my laptop, and it would cost 63,000 yen plus tax, which is about 613 US dollars to fix it. He didn't explain what the other issue was. I felt they were not honest with me. I thought that if I wanted to pay 613 US dollars to replace the battery, it would be better to buy a new laptop. Since I could use my computer without problems while connected to the power outlet, I canceled the service and asked them to return my computer. This is the letter Apple sent me. Thank you for selecting AppleCare service to ensure the highest level of quality and reliability. Apple approved technician perform all work using genuine Apple parts. After comprehensive testing, our technicians were able to diagnose your product's issues. We contacted you about the repair and you chose to cancel it. We are returning your product to you unrepaired. The following week, I found a computer repair shop in my city, took it there, and paid $26 to diagnose the problem. 3 days later, I received an email from the shop asking for 60,500 yen, about $535 to fix the problem. I went to the shop and asked one employee whether the problem was the battery or something else. He told me that the battery was okay. However, the problem could be related to an IC chip. I felt he was not honest with me either, because I had no issues with my MacBook when connected to the power outlet. I said thank you, paid their fee, and left the store. It became a stressful situation. I decided to run my laptop on electricity. However, the issue still bothered me, and I couldn't stop thinking about it. I thought, if the problem was neither the battery nor the logic board, it could be the battery board data connector. That's why the battery icon did not appear in the menu bar. So the battery icon was not here. Okay, I couldn't see this. Soon, I searched on Amazon and ordered a battery connection flex cable for 1,790 yen, about $10. This is the cable I purchased on Amazon. This one. It took 10 days to receive it. It arrived from China. I replaced the old cable with the new one. And surprisingly, the battery icon appeared in the menu bar. So I could see the battery icon here. My MacBook has been working flawlessly since I replaced the cable. It cost me around $123 altogether to solve the battery problem. It was a great experience and glad that I did it myself. Okay, let me show you the picture. Okay, this is the battery and this is the battery connection cable. The problem was this cable. First, I replaced the battery and then I replaced the cable. Okay, this is the one. Okay, that's why the battery couldn't communicate with the logic board. Therefore, I could not see the icon, the battery icon here. If you decide to replace the battery yourself, make sure you know how to do it and the risk involved. If you can find a shop to replace the battery at a reasonable price, ask them to do it for you. If you decide to do it yourself, watch a few movies on YouTube because you won't get all the necessary information just from watching one video. And above all, the priority is your safety. Make sure your computer is disconnected from the power outlet during the process of removing the old battery and installing a new one. I appreciate your patience in staying with me until the end. I just wanted to share my experience with you and thought you might have the same problem. I hope this video has been helpful. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks again.